Dear students, today we are going to talk about a third type of magnetic material known as ferromagnetic material. Well, this type of magnetic material shows the behavior which we are going to just discuss is happening at a temperature, lower temperature, less than a particular temperature for that material, known as Curie's temperature. And here we will see that the magnetism is slightly different, differently appearing in this case. Well, a ferromagnetic material can be looked upon as if it is divided in different groups, and these groups are called domains. In each group, the individual atomic magnetic dipoles or molecular dipoles, which is non-zero for this material, even in the absence of external magnetic field, but magnetic dipole moments or molecular dipole moments existing in this material are forming a group, and different groups are having magnetic dipole moments aligned in a different direction. That means the random arrangement of each group might cancel each other's magnetism, and therefore the material which is magnetic at the atomic level or molecular level may not show any magnetism in the absence of external magnetic field. Even if there is a weak external magnetic field, the material may not show any magnetism, because the magnetic dipoles or molecular dipoles of each group, each domain, remains in its own direction under the influence of a particular phenomena which is known as exchange coupling, and this is explained in quantum mechanics. At high level you will be able to understand. Well, under the influence of exchange coupling, each magnetic dipole moment are held aligned along one particular direction in a particular group, while in another group, that is another domain, the magnetic dipoles may be arranged all in one another direction. As shown in the figure you see here, we have taken four groups, four domains, and the magnetic dipoles are all arranged in different directions randomly, and such that the net magnetism is not showing up in the material. But when the ferromagnetic material is brought in strong magnetic field, external magnetic field, mind it, if we don't have a strong external magnetic field, it may not affect the ferromagnetic material. Therefore, we need a strong external magnetic field. When the this body is brought in the strong external magnetic field, the domains for which the magnetic dipoles are arranged along the external magnetic field grows in size by incurving the domain area of the neighboring domains, which are not aligned along the same direction in which the external magnetic field is directed. And those domains which are aligned in some opposite direction or aligned differently, their size is reduced under the influence of external magnetic field. And as a result, the ferromagnetic material, which was not showing magnetism in the absence of external magnetic field, now converts into a strong magnet. And stronger will be the field, larger will be the area of the domain for which the magnetic dipoles are arranged along the direction of external magnetic field, and stronger will be the magnetism produced in the ferromagnetic material. That is shown in figure 2. Here you see we have a strong magnetic field, external magnetic field shown by these parallel lines outside the magnet, and the domains which were aligned along the same direction of external magnetic field grew in size by incurving the area of neighboring domains, and also other domains were forced to change their direction either or reduce their area. And those which are not aligned along the external magnetic field, they reduce their size is reduced. So stronger will be the external magnetic field, greater will be the magnetism produced in the ferromagnetic material. Now the remarkable thing is that these domains, the magnetic dipole moments of dipole of these domains which are once aligned along one particular direction, do not change their direction under the influence of weak external magnetic field. It means that once the strong external magnetic field is removed, thereafter the ferromagnetic material retains strong magnetism, and it is holding this magnetism for a very long time. So this is different from the another magnetic materials we have talked. In case of diamagnetism, we saw that it is developing some magnetism which is always opposing the external magnetic field. In case of paramagnetic material, we have seen that the magnetic dipole are arranged along the external magnetic field, but it may not produce as strong magnetism as the ferromagnetic materials are producing, and as also the magnetism is retained for a much longer time by a ferromagnetic material once it is magnetized, as compared to that retained by paramagnetic material. So that's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.